this flowering plant deserves all the praise. Not only is it the smallest, not only is it the fastest growing, not only are they the most morphologically simple, it will feed you, give you medicine, clean your poopy water, and probably even solve the climate crisis. This is duckweed.
Hey, I'm Tasha the Amazon, and you're watching Floralogic. As you know, we love to explore the extremes of the plant world here. We've already covered the world's largest flowering plant, Rafflesia arnoldii, and today we're sliding down to the other extreme of the flowering plant spectrum and talking about the world's smallest flowering plant, duckweed. These flowers are seriously small. They're about the size of a pinhead.
Duckweed refers to a family of teeny tiny flowering plants of the Limnoideae subfamily. This family consists of 5 different genera, currently encompassing about 36 different species worldwide. Duckweed's structure consists of a frond without a stem, with some simpler species even lacking roots.
Depending on the species, about 40 to 75% of duckweed's mass is starch, but we'll get to why that's important later.
All duckweed species float freely on the surfaces of standing or slow-moving, fresh or slightly salty water. They love decaying matter under the surface, which gives these petite plants the nutrients they need to survive. They also love sunlight and tend to spread out wherever they find themselves.
When conditions are right, duckweed can multiply extremely quickly, doubling its biomass every 2 days and covering a whole acre of water surface in just 45.
Duckweed multiplies by vegetative reproduction, in which daughter fronds sprout from reproductive pockets of the parent plant. Each plant can reproduce as many as 10 times in its lifetime. Duckweed spreads easily through water channels or by hitchhiking on animals or waterfowl.
You can do it, buddy. Oh, look, he's got...
These are some of the most effective species on the planet.
So while water might flow off a duck's back, duckweed certainly doesn't.
Duckweed might look like algae from a distance, but get up close and you'll see that algae gathers in a mass, while duckweed is made up of tiny individual plants. Duckweed and algae, in fact, are in constant competition with each other for resources.
But in this battle of pipsqueak pond dwellers, duckweed, with its ability to block out surface light, almost always wins, killing off the algae below. Because it's so aggressive in its spread, you're probably wondering if duckweed is classified as an invasive species. Well, the answer to this is sort of yes and sort of no. While it is native to most regions it grows in, when it overtakes the entire surface of a body of water, it behaves like an invasive species.
For starters, duckweed sucks all the dissolved oxygen out of the water. Not only that, it also creates a physical barrier between the water surface and the air above, preventing more oxygen from reaching the water. Together, these factors create an anaerobic environment below. This usually spells death for fish and other creatures that need oxygen in the water to survive.
Additionally, blocking out the sun means that pathogens that are normally killed by UV light can thrive. All that to say, duckweed can make things stink. Imagine leaving the lid on a container of soup for way too long.
The creatures that inhabit duckweed-covered water find lots of uses for it. Ducks, for example, feed extensively on these tiny morsels, which is probably where they got their name. Other species like muskrat, beavers, frogs, herons, snails, and fish will also gobble up this starchy food source. Damsel and dragonflies will rest on duckweed and lay their eggs among them.
Under the surface, minuscule protozoans will take cover by clinging onto the duckweed's tiny rootlets and use them as a home base for gathering their own food.
When they're not busy eating it, duckweed is also used by amphibians, like frogs, to hide from predators. It's a hideout you can never get hungry in. On the flip side, duckweed also gives predators, like crocodiles, the perfect place to launch an ambush on unsuspecting prey.
But it's not just animals that make good use of duckweed. We humans, too, use duckweed for more than you'd ever guess.
Duckweed is high in protein, fatty acids, and other good stuff, making these plants seriously nutritious. Because of this, duckweed makes great fodder for livestock and has been used as such for hundreds of years. Since it can be grown hydroponically, it doesn't compete with the livestock themselves for land. And because it multiplies so quickly and can be simply scooped off the surface, it takes a lot less effort to grow and harvest large amounts compared to other animal feed.
Even we humans can't pass up the chance for some major plant-based protein and nutrients. Duckweed has long been consumed by people in Asia and is now being turned into everything from vitamin B12 and iron supplements to protein powder. The medicinal uses of duckweed have been long known in China and Korea. Certain species have antibacterial and antimicrobial properties, with other species being clinically investigated for the treatment of ailments from lung cancer to colon disease.
Duckweed is also being investigated as a candidate for wastewater treatment from places like municipal sewage treatment plants, livestock industries, and food processing plants. It can grow quickly when it's in water that's packed full of dissolved nutrients, like ammonia and phosphorus, but it can also filter out pathogens and toxins, so it's effective to purify water.
The fact, too, that it outcompetes algae, including crazy toxic blue-green algae, makes it great for wastewater processing. And as if it's not doing enough already, duckweed may also help us address the energy crisis by offering a sustainable alternative to fossil fuels.
Remember when I said duckweed is bonkers high in starch? That starchiness means that duckweed is also perfect for the production of liquid biofuels, specifically bioethanol. Similar to the process of making booze, yeast converts that starch to ethanol, otherwise known as alcohol. This duckweed bioethanol can then be used as an alternative to gasoline.
But not as an alternative to your favorite beer, unfortunately. So now I ask, what can't duckweed do? The answer is nothing, except maybe host an episode of Flora Logic. Thanks for joining me, your perpetually human host, on this dip into duckweed. So what should we talk about next? Let me know in the comments, and don't forget to subscribe for new episodes every week. Bye. Hi, I'm Tasha the Amazon, and you're watching Flora Logic. You know?
You know plants?
No, I mean it. It's true. I swear to God, my mom told me. Depending on the species, about 40 to 75% of a duckweed's mass is starch.
The conditions are perfect for me to double my biomass.
Oh, come on, Blaze. Let me tell you something about Blaze. He sucks. But he doesn't suck. I love him. I'm engaged to him. He makes great cocktails. Colin, show them your cocktail.
Party for you.
Get it? Makes the soup. Smell like poop. I scratch my nose. I don't pick it. I scratch it.
Okay.
Oh my God. Don't get in the comments and say she picked her nose on camera. You can zoom in and you can see. It's a scratch. So what should we talk about next? Drop your recos in the comments below. I don't say recos. I would never say such a word.